Okay, good.
So you guys were gonna head to the generator then?
Well, can I have a water?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh wait, you had a potion about seeing in the dark, right?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, so here's the story. You already rolled to get potions, but now you have to roll to activate potions to see if this one will actually
let you see in the dark. Okay, so roll just potions then?
Yeah, so
okay.
You get two dice for this.
So you can see in the dark and not be blind.
Ah! Okay. Oh, and I can make it a skill.
She can.
All right, so you get night vision potions, three.
Oh, perfect.
All right, nice. Well done. So, yeah, he does in fact have a potion that lets you see in the dark.
Check it out. Oh, you see my eyes are just glowing green.
How are we supposed just to know like if it's working or not?
His eyes are glowing green.
It could be a potion of, green glowing eyes.
I didn't put the glow sticks into my brain, okay? This is happening.
So now that you can see in
I'm
the dark,
skeptical.
You see
skeptical.
Off in the distance around by the zipper and the cotton candy stand. There are a bunch of people, they look like your fellow employees, running all around, and you see, it looks like someone maybe on stilts running after them maybe, but then they all disappear behind a tent.
We get a new carny, it's on stilts?
No, maybe? I think Carl had a fractured, eye.
Yeah.
He definitely did.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Carl
yeah,
couldn't
yeah.
see
yeah.
so well, couldn't yeah. use stilts. So yeah. who's this
right.
guy? I just saw a guy on stilts.
Maybe they got a new stilt guy.
They wouldn't get a new stilt guy without asking us. Come on.
That's true. That's reliable, he thinks.
They wouldn't replace Carl.
I know, yeah.
We're going to find out about
Carl's
this.
Carl's the best there is.
It's come true. On, over by
wait,
the
wait.
Zipper.
Are you going to find out about that, or are you going to get to the main generator tent?
Well, we'd have to see. Well, I guess you can see.
What's more important here, our livelihood or the power?
Isn't that kind of both?
Well, were you all for making good points?
I don't think that's a good point.
Resist it. Stop lomeling it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, you actually so do think it's a good point.
You're the smart one here.
Yes, I know, thank you.
So, Lisa Frank.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Yes. Contessa Elizabeth Franciscus?
No, it's just Lisa Frank.
Lisa Frank. Lisa Frank. To her friends. You gain making good points, too.
Thank you.
All right, so, yeah. She makes a good point, you guys. It is your livelihood. It's both that we get the power restored to this carnival.
Yeah, we should probably go do that.
Well, it'll probably make the rest of the stuff easier to
and
do.
And then we could see who was on the stilts.
Oh, God, she's so good at that.
Because the lights would be on.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so you guys are going to try and make your way to the generator tent.
Yes.
Which of you have been to the main generator tent before?
Oh,
never in my life.
None of you.
Not worried about the singeing.
I don't even know if it exists, honestly.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure it does.
I thought it was a myth that everyone was whispering.
Right.
Tents.
Of the generator tent.
I mean, has anybody actually ever seen it?
Not in person. I know a guy who knows a guy who used to work on it.
You remember hearing of a man named Brady who once knew where the generator tent was.
Yeah.
But you don't remember who... You know there's a guy named Brady that works here at the carnival. You can't remember in what capacity, but you know... Yeah, you've definitely heard that he knows where.
When did we hire the Brady Bunch? I thought they were out of town.
I don't think so.
Hmm. Well, are we going to do this thing or not?
I guess we just start calling out Brady?
Yeah, why not?
Brady!
What?
Oh.
Oh.
That, was
that works really well.
Yeah, no, I was just standing right over here and...
Oh, we thought you were out of town. You and the rest of the bunch.
What?
Because obviously there's a whole group.
Nah, it's just me.
No.
Well, hey, do you know where the generator tent is?
Yeah, I remember hearing about a generator tent once. You know, back when I first started working at this carnival, you know, before we got into the whole, like, divesting people of their souls business, I remember hearing that there was a generator tent somewhere back behind the Crazy Mouse roller coaster.
But you've never actually seen
it. I saw it. Someone, the person who told me that, they pointed to a tent behind the Crazy Mouse roller coaster. Mm. And I can only assume.
Well, who told you that?
Jeff?
Jeff.
Of course Jeff. It was Jeff.
Of course it was Jeff.
Jeff is such a goof.
Yeah. I've never been a fan of Jeff since day one. No. I'll tell you that much.
But he's always cracking wise.
You know what?
I
the lights are off.
Him.
We might as well just go see if there's even a tent there. Who knows with Jeff?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't remember where it was we set up the crazy mouse this time. You know, this area is all weird because of the copses of trees.
Copses. Yeah.
Copses? I always say copses.
I'm from the East Coast. I don't know.
I'm embarrassed.
Yeah.
And, so I don't really remember. What happened to the lights?
They're off. Because someone.
I think a kid unplugged it.
Come on, Narc.
Are you narking? Wait, you don't you have a skill? Oh, you don't have a skill in Narc. Do you want to resist?
Do I resist?
Narking?
Yeah.
Damn it! Oh, so you attempt to shout her down, but she just rings out clearly.
It was a kid. Yeah.
It was. It was definitely a kid.
Definitely a monkey.
It was a big monkey kid.
A child actor.
You're describing yourself, Buzz.
Oh,
yeah.
Big
got there,
monkey
Buzz.
Kid child actor.
Yeah. That's time, Buzz.
Everybody knows that.
We all know you did a commercial when you were younger.
So anyway, he unplugged it because he thought that was a good idea.
Well, yeah, for that, you'd have to go to the main generator tent, most likely. I assume. I mean, I sell the fried hot dogs here.
Those are delicious.
Man, you do a really good job.
Yeah, the secret is putting the ketchup and mustard
afterwards.
On before you drop them in the fryer.
Oh. Mm.
You probably shouldn't let that be common knowledge.
Well, I'm just telling you guys, it's not common knowledge. It's carny code.
Yeah, that's carny code. What's the hand gesture we do after that? Just this?
Carny code. No. Do you guys all do a different hand
gesture? Everyone. No one's quite sure.
Exactly.
What it is.
Exactly. Yeah, so you'd have to find the crazy mouse. Behind that, I imagine that'd still be part of the carnival floor plan. Yard plan. Copes plan? Cops plan, sorry.
Cops! That's how we say it in Connecticut, where I'm from.
Why don't we just ask Princess, huh? She'd know.
We have to find her first.
Princess? Oh. Who?
Jingle Jangle.
Jingle Jangle.
Princess Jingle Jangle.
Princess was busy with three boys that tried to sneak in through the fence earlier. I don't know that Princess is, she could be done with that now. They were trying, they couldn't resist the siren song in the House of Horrors that was going to age them horribly and leave them
a pile of
dust.
Don't we have maps that we give to all the guests?
Oh yeah, I can't.
Can't we just... look at one of those?
Okay, hold on. Do we? Let's find out.
Do we?
You roll.
And then I have an idea.
No, we don't have maps.
There's no need to see if you paint them.
Maybe I do straight up paint don't exist. Them, they just aren't real. Like, nobody actually passes them out.
That is very hard for me to wrap my head around. So I'm going to nix
she sits
that.
In her room at night painting maps by herself.
No one's going to see these ever. What were you
she dreams
say?
Of being a cartographer.
Contingent on maps.
Okay, yeah. Well, that whole train.
We went all in on maps.
Now contingency plan just
all right,
fell
well, how about a sign? Do we have one of those?
A sign? What,
like a sign from above?
Oh, or like
you
a
know,
signpost? To...
Like a signpost.
Oh, yeah that points which way to...
Yeah.
Yeah.
A face painter?
Yeah.
Wait. Oh, that was a roll for...
I rolled five.
That was a great roll, and I wish I could give that to you, but that was... you do paint the signs.
Yeah.
But you don't paint them with words. Someone tells you what the sign is supposed
feeling.
To convey, and you sort of paint things that convey that.
Well, what was my six rolled?
That one, actually, I was getting her to roll, so that was a waste of a six.
Fine.
I apologize. You know what?
I didn't roll a six for knowing that there are signs.
Let's give you, knowing there are signs, too. We'll see if that ever comes into play. I'll give
you
that
know?
To you, though.
No, I've always liked her signs because I can't read. You all know that.
Yeah.
I need to see them.
However, they're really hard to interpret because it really is contingent on you having the same emotions when looking at those things that the sign painter wanted you to
Which
have.
Which everyone does.
Yeah.
Was there a sign nearby we could look at? Me decipher?
Brady is gone.
Where did he go?
Brady! This worked last time. Brady!
No. Nope.
Ah, damn it.
It's not working. Everyone make a roll for me real quick.
Are you trying to summon Brady?
There will be no experience for failing this
six.
One.
There's
I
another
just
six.
Want to see if anyone.
Wow.
I got sixes.
I've already run out of dice. No, wait, there we go.
What did we get a six for?
Hold on, so everyone, remember what you rolled.
Oh. Okay. Stop fumbling.
I'm sorry, it's hard. I'm very far away.
Three.
Okay, did everyone beat a three?
No.
Yeah.
Yes. I did not?
No.
Okay.
Everybody else did, though.
We got
four.
Six.
Yes. And then you guys
sixes.
Got sixes.
Yes.
So you guys, except for you, you're distracted, maybe. Oiling a snake. you notice a patch
I really hope that's what he's
of
doing.
Blood, maybe body tissue, on the ground where Brady was standing.
and one part of a shoe. Not a whole shoe.
Can I roll to faint?
Sure.
Nice.
Nice.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, boy.
She may not faint. That's a D12. Why don't you guys let me roll a D12? All right, so you faint. And you gain fainting too. And then also, you guys also both gain noticing too.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, wait, that's a
just the two of them. Whew, that's a lot of things. So, yeah, she totally, straight
she
up
faints. I watch her faint.
Okay.
And go, huh.
Nobody grabs her.
Nope.
No. What happened to her?
But it's like really quick fainting. I'm like, oh, what was that?
Yeah, but your head hits the ground real solidly.
I'm gonna with my steel-toed boot. I'm gonna kind of push the viscera around.
It's not a lot of viscera. It doesn't take a lot of time.
Okay. Yeah.
What are you trying to glean from the viscera?
See if there's anything in there.
Are we sure we want to turn the lights back on?
Well, part of a shoe and a toe comes out of it.
Okay.
Oh can I faint again?
Are you not already unconscious?
No, she got unconscious.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
So, she faints again. Anyone catch
her? But then I get back. Oh.
What'd you say?
No, no one catches you.
No, not at all.
Ow!
No.
And then I get back up. That was gross. Please don't do that.
So, electrical generator. I have to imagine, considering the state of the rest of our carnival, that it's probably not in very good repair and probably smells a bit of, like, electrical fire. And I'd like to think that I've had a few really close calls at the carnival with my beard almost catching on fire, so I'm really sensitive to the smell of things that might catch my beard on fire.
Wait, hold.
Okay.
Wait.
So maybe we can find it based off of the smell.
Was that a toe?
Are you guys still hung up on that?
Well, there was a toe inside of
that.
There.
Can we do, like, that's a thing that already happened.
No. Is that okay with just toe?
We should return it to his family at least, right? I pick up the toe and I put it.
I would like to put it
in my mini pockets.
All right, you have a toe. Write that down.
To make everyone feel better, I'm going to turn this pile of viscera into a puppy.
Oh no!
And then we're just going to throw
okay, hold on.
It.
Wait. Like the, so okay. So okay. Yeah.
If this fails, it's going to be really bad.
This is going to be a really hard thing to do. With
no
preparation, you're going to turn a pile of viscera into a puppy.
I'm going to turn a pile of viscera into a puppy.
Go for it. But,
okay. Yes!
Hold on.
Oh!
Yeah.
Okay.
Still a six.
So you both fail and gain a skill. So you kind of get down by the pile of viscera when everyone's talking about the toe and he's pocketing it, and you just quickly kind of like manipulate it into like a puppy-shaped mound of viscera, and then with a little puff of glitter go, ta-da!
Oh my god, why?
That's gross.
Can I why?
And it starts.
Here, I don't have any, damn it.
I thought it would make everyone feel better.
It's a 10, I can't, yeah.
Here, now, can I this time catch her and cushion her head on my beard?
Roll resourceful beard. Yeah, good, because otherwise she's going to get majorly concussed if she keeps playing at this rate. So you gained a skill.
Oh, thank you. That's crazy.
Oh, man. Bizarrely morbid magic tricks, too.
Okay, Katniss.
All right.
You know?
And, yeah,
you never
so you catch
know
her
when
with
that
your
might
beard.
Come in handy.
I've been doing some thinking.
Really? How did you have the time?
Don't hurt yourself.
Why don't we find an extension cord and then follow it back to the source?
That's actually a good point.
You know what? We wouldn't even be.
I can trust it from her.
Is it, right? though?
We wouldn't even be in this scenario if it wasn't for this guy.
That's also
so. I don't know why anyone thinks we
it was a monkey kid.
Don't be so hard on Buzz.
How many times I gotta tell you?
You know what? Every single time something bad happens, I swear it's Buzz. It's always Buzz.
Oh, don't be so hard on Buzz.
It's always Buzz.
This conflict is tearing this suddenly formed group of random, not friendly carnies apart. And as you stand here in the middle of the open clearing by the Tilt-A-Whirl, arguing. Near a pile of viscera that looks sort of like a melting puppy. You start to hear the sound of distant crunching footsteps approaching.
Guys, you hear that sound of distant crunching footsteps approaching?
No, I don't hear it. Hold on, I will hear it though.
Wait, you already hear it.
You already have a potion of hearing.
But I want to hear it better.
Do it.
I want to identify it before it gets here.
This is gas analysis all over again.
Gas analysis.
Wait, hold on. That first one was a 2, right?
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Oh, it's a 6 now, though.
No, it's not. 5. All right, you drink your potion of listening.
And I know what this is.
It sounds like a,
very
tall man.
Very tall man.
In worker's boots.
Worker's boots.
Coming purposefully.
Coming purposefully.
Towards the 5 of you.
Towards us!
So maybe we should move in the opposite direction.
That's not the point. Brady Cat, come on.
I'm not really scared of tall men in worker's boots.
Go get them.
See?
We'll be over there.
You all start to hear, accompanying the crunching sounds, which are getting closer, a low murmuring, and it sounds like someone whispering, of his own, they were 4 men, of his own, they were 4 men, and it's getting closer and closer.
Oh boy.
I pull out the shiv that I keep in my beard as well.
Roll for that.
Ooh,
yep. Handy-dandy shiv. Always keep that in your beard.
Never leave the tent without it.
Right.
I'm going to pull a magic wand out of my sleeve.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Is it an actual magic wand or just a prop?
It's a one.
Well,
so.
It is a prop. Magic wand. And you actually forgot it back in your dressing room.
Look how many of these I have.
You should spend those.
Nice.
Can I spend them on whatever I want?
You can spend them on whatever you want. Like, if you want to have actually... If you want to actually have had the ability to produce a magic wand, despite not being able to do it right then.
I do.
Okay, then give me one of those. And you gain
magic.
And it's
a real magic wand.
You gain magic wand too. We'll go from there.
It's
a magic wand.
Vaguely magical.
Maybe there's quotes around the magic part. We can't know that. So are you guys moving? Are you moving or are you staying where you are?
I'm gonna say hello.
I'ma leave.
We're quarantined, okay? This is our home. We gotta invite people in.
I'm going to go hide.
I'm going to disguise all of us with glitter except for him.
Okay.
Sounds like we have a bunch of different plans here right now. Okay, so you're gonna stay and say hi. You're gonna leave.
I'm gonna hide behind the nearest box.
You're gonna hide. You're gonna disguise everyone with glitter.
I'm gonna disguise the remaining people with glitter.
I'm gonna roll
my glitter feet.
I'm gonna stay right here and be disguised.
Okay, so and be disguised. So so you guys are living all together in this carnival, but you have never heard anyone that sounds like this before. Just letting you know. Mm-hmm. That's a heads up there. All right, so let's start with making a hide roll.
Woohoo! I'm out, bitch! Oh.
Yep.
Oh, darn it.
Stop it.
I can't.
Okay.
Whoa. All right. So you find nearby a cardboard cutout of a man-sized figure letting someone know that they have to be this tall to ride. So you go over and hide in front of it, making the same shape as the guy.
Oh,
Buzz. Good idea. Bad execution. You guys are standing your ground, and you...
I'm gonna roll for feats of glitter.
Feats of glitter.
Wouldn't that make you more visible?
Whoa!
If you make six, you can upgrade it. So you would get 3 for your next one.
So hold on. This is going to be difficult, because throwing glitter on people to make them harder to see is somewhat counterintuitive.
Yeah.
Maybe the glitter gets in people's eyes.
I think it's looking good for
a
you.
Success.
Yeah, so you win.
Yeah.
Do you want to spend...
Also, I want to get another point in glitter feats.
Okay, so spend that.
Spend that.
So 1 experience point is all you need.
Oh, yeah.
And you can turn that into me. And you get...
I have glitter feats 3.
No, it's not glitter feats. It's a more specific skill related to glitter feats. So this is going to be glitter of darkness.
Glitter of darkness. 3. Oh, man. That is my drag queen name.
So you throw up a big puff of glitter that seems to absorb the light from the air around it. And it settles on all of your friends, except for Buzz, who is currently pretending to be a you must be this high.
Buzz makes poor light choices.
Yeah, well, we knew that. So the 4 of you are now effectively invisible, just patches of darkness in an otherwise dark night.
Well, you didn't pick me, did you?
No, you were
said
doing
not me.
Oh, what
something
were you doing?
I was gonna go say hi to
He was gonna go say hi to one.
You were gonna go say hi. Make a quick roll, both of you, just 1 die to see if you accidentally got caught in that glitter.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay, sure.
Oh,
shit. What?
You're partially obscured by glitter?
So
blurry.
Yeah. Yeah, your torso was obscured by the glitter, but your legs were not.
Oh, that's gonna be freaky.
Yeah, it is.
That's gonna be real freaky.
You look like a pair of jeans. walking around.
Well,
right,
I can't
now.
Say hello to anybody like this.
Well, you definitely can, because you don't know what happened. So oh, you guys right. are all standing there. And you hear the crunching getting closer and the murmuring as well. And suddenly an impossibly tall man, you assume, figure, dressed in what appears to be an old Victorian style ringmaster's outfit. But with very, very long legs, he's about 7 feet tall, comes striding into the clearing, and hand extended was like, I heard someone here a moment ago, but where? Meanwhile, you're walking up to him, not knowing you've been covered in darkness.
Okay,
yeah,
can I
guess so.
Can I attempt to throw my voice to convince that there's a voice coming from somewhere else?
And then what are you going to do?
Stand there in fear?
Stand there in fear? Yeah. Then yes.
Okay. Oh, what is it?
Cocked die.
Infinity.
Cocked
die.
What?
Oh. Guys, we'll get it. I promise you.
Get it. You know what?
Yay!
Yeah! Oh!
So you gain ventriloquism.
Yeah.
Ventriloquism too. But he is not fooled. You throw your voice off some other part of the carnival. What do you say?
Hey, there are small kids over here, unattended.
So you say that, and it does sound like a Midwestern mother off in the carnival is announcing that these small children are unattended, like Midwestern mothers would do.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And his head swivels over there, but then stops. No. No, they're here. They tried to convince me that there are people here to save them, yet they were all alone. And he starts skulking through the area where you guys are all hiding.
I want to shank first and ask questions later.
Okay. Shank away, but this is just a regular D6 roll.
I know.
Can't use your beard this time.
Oh, God. Oh.
Or can she?
Oh, my God.
So you gain shanking, too, wow. But you also shankin'. Fail. So you, how does a bearded lady shank? Is there like a battle
menacingly.
Cry or something that is shouted, or is it silent but deadly?
Actually, I'm just imagining that scene in Spaceballs where it just literally is like, I'm the bearded lady!
That's okay. Exactly. Yes,
for no reason. Okay. I just feel like I need to announce it.
That works really well for me mentally.
Yeah. I'm right there.
So you announce that and go to slash at his leg, which is passing right by you, but you just stab it right through his impossibly billowy pants and don't seem to actually connect to anything solid underneath there, and you pull your shank back out, and he whips his head back down to you, and you don't see anything underneath the brim of his very tall ringmaster's top hat, just shrouded darkness. And he points his finger out in your general direction, because he doesn't still know exactly where you are.
Yeah, glitter of darkness.
Which one of you bearded individuals tried to shank
me? Oh shit, the narc's gotta say something.
I'm gonna attempt to use my magic wand.
Resist narking.
to cast a...
He reaches
magic
onto his back and pulls out a bayonet.
Ooh.
Yeah, oh. A really wicked
I'm
sharp
going to attempt to use my magic wand to turn that bayonet into a bouquet of flowers.
Okay. just give me a real quick roll.
Just
right
a real
now.
Just real quick.
One, yeah. Two, or three. It is not a magic wand. So that's okay. That doesn't stop you from doing
it's
this.
Not gonna,
okay, so make your roll for
gonna,
magic wand.
Still gonna do it.
Roll two.
Oh, I rolled two.
Hold on.
I unclipped my mic.
Oh no.
I'm really getting into this, guys. Okay. Roll your two dice.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh. Wow. Yikes.
So, forgetting for a moment that you are an illusionist, not you know, an actual magician. Which
wizard.
Really works on so many. Yeah, sure, we'll say wizard, but yeah. An illusionist still a subsection. You shoot out your magic wand and accidentally produce a bouquet of flowers from within the magic wand, which goes springing out at this guy's back, showering plastic flowers all around him. What is this? What?
Can I?
He seems confused.
Can I narc, but like make it a lie and go, who is that bearded guy over there?
No, you can't lie when you're narking.
You can't lie when you're narking.
Narking is the thing. Now, if you want to try and fake narc with a new skill, you can do that.
What does that mean? Yeah, I don't have narking as a skill.
Oh, you don't?
No.
Oh, so you're farking.
Oh, so farking.
That's what we call it, right?
Yeah, yeah. Farking.
Totally farking it. Okay. Yeah.
Woo! Whoa.
Nice.
Successful farking.
All right. So you fake narc, otherwise known as just lying.
It is farking.
And what do you say?
It was that bearded guy over there. Obviously, it's what I say.
All right. And even though he can't see you and where you're pointing, he still seems to intuit the general direction that you're indicating with your voice
of course.
And your fark.
He swivels his head
and begins stalking off into the darkness towards that direction, muttering to himself again, till the one day, off into the darkness and disappears into the night. Oh, you saw all of this in great detail.
Oh my god.
Wow, guys, that was weird. Hey, I didn't know that trick actually worked.
So, do you think he's replacing
Carl? It sort
of
didn't.
Or is he just like some creepy guy? I mean, they wouldn't use him.
They wouldn't replace Carl, right? Carl with that guy.
Right?
That was no man I've ever seen.
Right. He kind of looked like my uncle.
Whoa. Oh, yeah.
I can see that.
Yeah. I mean, illusionist
family. You guys all know
families.
Her uncle?
Yeah. Who doesn't know her uncle?
Jeremy from Boston.
Yeah. Oh, from Boston. Sorry.
Those Bostonian illusionists are a rare breed.
He's got a YouTube channel. It's really good. You should check it out.
But it's not for magic, is it?
That's
it's
good.
Like,
no.
He tastes different pretzels from around the town. And
he just has like vlogs and stuff where he just updates about his day. It's really cool. He's a really cool guy.
I'm not going to watch that.
He's got a schnauzer.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But it wasn't
you
like
guys are
Uncle
now
Jeremy.
Telling this for me.
It wasn't like Uncle Jeremy at all, though.
No.
Seemed otherworldly. I don't know.
Yeah. Very unlike
you Uncle Jeremy. You clearly don't know Uncle Jeremy.
Where the face should be.
Not one you could see.
Who uses a bayonet?
I don't know. He didn't even have a gun.
Really
he just whipped out a bayonet.
But the way he reached into his back, I could tell he wanted a bayonet. But then it was flowers. I don't know what happened.
No. It was a bayonet.
It was a bayonet,
and
for
then
sure.
And suddenly flowers just started falling.
Right. Typically, you attach a bayonet to the end of a musket. But,
that's right. That's
this guy's forward thinking.
He only just pulled out the knife part.
Although, it really doesn't matter if he had a bayonet or not.
Well,
we should
because
probably...
colloquially, you all remember, a bayonet can also be used to refer to a gun with a blade at the end of it. Colloquially, as most people understand it, you think in your heads, and it suddenly becomes canon.
I just sort of remembered a little something. We should discuss later when we're having our nightly tea.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So should we still try and turn the lights back on?
Yeah.
Probably. Yeah.
I'm gonna do my idea and find an extension cord and follow it back.
Cast about for an extension cord.
Okay.
In the darkness.
No problem.
Because sometimes
this
just are.
This will not be an issue for me.
I assume you're...
Whatsoever.
So I'm sure your darkness glitter, because it's so dark, it probably just falls off of things after a little bit.
Yeah.
Not like regular
glitter,
which is
sticky. We didn't use darkness
sticky.
Glitter primer.
Right.
So.
Yeah, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So you still have your glow stick.
Yeah.
But I have this beautiful glitter beard now.
Yeah.
I'm very trendy.
Very. Instagram would love you.
Typically in this situation, to find an extension cord, you would start digging. So I'm just going to go ahead and dig a hole here.
He does.
And,
okay. I mean, the man knows.
There should be
stuff.
One about 3 feet down.
Like a dog burying a bone.
Yeah, so I'm
has no tool.
Scrabble into the
so
earth.
So maybe I should just roll for knowing there are signs?
I kind of also want to go and try my plan of being able to smell things that might set my beard on fire, because I'm pretty sure it's a
useful,
bad electrical thing.
That's a useful skill.
Is that a skill you have? You want to try and
see if you can... Well, I have a resourceful beard, but not so much things that
beard
might...
sensing? Beard a-sensing?
So
sensitive beard.
Yeah, roll for that. Roll for that. Let's see if that's actually a thing that you can actually do. So roll resourceful beard.
All right.
And we'll see if your resourceful beard is resourceful enough to...
Is this only for rerolls, or can I upgrade a skill with it?
You can turn any die roll into a 6 with it. So if you roll a 6 with these two things, then you can make it a skill.
I want resourceful beard to be a higher skill check.
Yeah, that's not...
Hold on.
It's not how fire works.
So that would only change one of your die into a 6, not both.
You need both of them to be 16.
Yeah, since it's a two rank skill, you need to have both of them be sixes in order to further specialize. Yeah. So,
who wants to join me in digging this hole?
Wait. Come don't on. Dig. What I got night here? Vision potions.
You smell a bunch of glitter. It's really messing with your beard's ability to detect flammable things.
I got night vision potions.
You notice.
Although, it'll help me dig faster.
Looking over his stupid hunch. That was a failure, yes.
Oh, I get one too.
So, hold on. So, you got an experience point for that. So, you can immediately spend both of those to make both of those a six. If you want to be able to detect flammable things with your beard.
I have those. Back,
and you gain detecting flammable things 3. but you were not, because of the glitter, able to get a read right now.
Right.
You see over his stupid hunched digging form. Sorry to form a GM opinion there.
No. I have a visual.
The fortune-telling tent is behind him. And it appears there is a soft light emanating from within.
Wait a minute.
How's that even possible?
There's a light on in there.
Maybe there's more glow sticks.
Oh, maybe, yeah.
Well, let's go take a look.
Who's working the fortune-telling tent?
I thought it was Sweet Mary.
No, I think it's Beatrice.
Beatrice.
Madam Beatrice. That's right. I can hear all of you out there.
Oh, she's sitting there. Oh,
God.
I've been eavesdropping and cold reading you this whole time. Come in here and just see if I can't tell your future.
Beatrice, how do you have light?
It's a candle, dum-dum.
She's so terrible.
Yeah. She's the worst.
Wait, candle?
I can still hear all of you.
I face-painted her face one time, and it turned out terrible. Nothing I could do made it look nice.
That was on you, sweetheart.
No.
Listen, are you all coming in here or what?
We should probably go over
there. We should go in.
So
I'm going to roll to resist Beatrice's unpleasantness.
Okay, you can do that.
I can do that.
Okay, so make your roll. Beatrice is very unpleasant.
You can take that.
She's very unpleasant.
All right, yeah, you do.
You
and
have one
do you
six.
Want to make that into a better skill?
Yeah.
Okay, so spend an experience point.
There you go.
And you gain, what is it called? When you're trying to go along with someone, you're trying to, placating unpleasant people. So you all file into the fortune teller's tent where Madam Beatrice is sitting beside her table with her crystal ball and one black candle dripping wax. There's a stuffed crow on the chair behind her that looks like it's been eaten by moths. And you file in into her tent. What?
Beatrice, you know, you look great today. I think, did you do something different with your tooth?
I did. I put it in the other socket today.
It's good.
Well, thank
it's
you for
good.
Noticing.
I appreciate it.
No, this is good. Yeah, I like it.
Hey, don't just piggyback onto her compliment.
I'm just saying, you know, you do look good. You know, last time we went out, I didn't think you did, but now, looking pretty sweet.
Yeah, that's not scoring you any points, Murphy. What do you guys want?
You called us in here.
That's true.
We're actually there's some weirdness, like a greater than usual concentration of weirdness.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm hiding in my tent.
Yeah,
hiding. Well, you got the only light on here. You're gonna be found pretty easy.
No.
So we're trying
No.
We're trying to see if we can get the lights turned back on, but we can't seem to find
the generator tent.
The generator tent.
I knew she was gonna say that.
You know, you're so smart, Beatrice. Maybe you could use your cards and see if the cards can tell us where the generator tent is.
Perhaps I could. Perhaps I could at that. I shall deal each of you one card. And we'll read you five as a group. Although maybe not you, Murphy.
Oh.
You made me go Dutch on the bill.
Oh.
I'm gonna need to switch my tooth for this.
Oh
boy, that's when you know it's serious.
Yes, I do, I faint.
So we'll call this one Rapid fainting and recovery, or minor things 3.
Okay.
It's good. Cookies.
So she deals you a card, Buzz. The lovers. All right, it appears that the cards are gonna tell us a story. All right, they tell us a story of when this lady right here met this fellow right here. Uh-huh. Okay?
She deals you a card.
Mac is just like, that's not the tarot works.
The tower.
Look, if I didn't have this beard, that would have been the other position I wanted here.
I sense your cynicism.
Oh, do you?
But we do not question the Madam Beatrice.
No. I question her.
Let
it's not a good idea.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that about you.
Roll the questioner.
Oh.
All right, well, you can question all you want, but that doesn't make you right. Okay.
Doesn't make me wrong either.
Maybe not. But that's up for all of them to decide. The tower. A place fortified against all who would seek to enter. Much like the generator tent. I don't know. I'm just spitballing here. The hanged man.
Oh.
Do you want to faint?
Yeah, you're probably going to faint.
Just real quick, it's a minor thing.
This is real minor. Mm.
So, I'm not even going to roll against that. Just
yeah,
do
I
it.
Did. Mm-hmm. But now I'm back.
I can't beat that. Anytime you want to faint really minorly at things, unless it's super hard to do, you just can't.
The hanged man tells us to follow our intuition, right? Yeah, that's right, because I'm giving the reading, and that's what it means. And they knew that this was much more than a hunch that you needed to get to the generator tent, right? Because,
flips over the next card, the fool. She casts a side eye at you, Murphy.
Come on!
It's a long side eye.
With the other eye still going that way.
No, that's Jingle Jangles. Oh. She's got a tooth she can move around.
Because it was surf and turf, Murphy. That's not a cheap meal, even though we split it.
You still smell like shrimp.
Get to you. The fool indicates forces at work outside beyond your control that cannot be reasoned with, cannot be outsmarted. Right? Right?
Actually,
is this okay? Can I keep going?
It kind of sounds like Beatrice has a point.
It sounds like she's just been watching what we've been doing and is just laying out.
And she flips over a final card.
The asshole. Who made me go Dutch?
That was custom drawn. Look at that.
I'm a servant turf. Murphy.
I get it. I didn't pay the bill.
Look, that's why we call him Murph and Turf. He's just known.
He also made me pay the tip. Can you believe that? Dutch, and then I had to tip the guy because he left his cash at home.
No.
I don't even like her, but that's low.
I did leave my cash at home.
You're a monster, Murphy.
Everybody's made the mistake.
The asshole, despite being a card that I may have made up and inserted into my deck custom,
does mean
that this group must somehow form a family to face the odds and find the generator tent.
Are you saying we have to get down to business?
Yeah.
To defeat the
Huns?
With
our Huns here?
What? No. I'm
gonna faint.
I did it. Can I roll for weirdly appropriate Disney lyrics?
Sure.
Darn it.
Hold on.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm. You sent him daughters.
Now is not the time, Rizabella, and don't you jump in on this.
Sorry.
Don't you change your voice to mirror mine.
I've been talking this way the whole time.
I don't know. I'm still thinking about that group, that Brady Bunch group.
Hmm? Yeah. Anyway. We established there was only one Brady.
Yeah, well, I don't think so, because there's some hijinks going on here.
Wait, you guys have seen Brady?
Well,
yeah, he and I were supposed to meet up tonight.
Oh, what is this about now?
You can meet up with him right now.
Brady,
you didn't see that coming?
She wanted to see him.
You didn't see that coming?
Oh my God.
I mean, you know all these things.
This is Brady's toe. pretty much just as I foretold.
Did you?
It was just a random toe, I thought.
No, that was Brady's toe.
This is definitely Brady's toe.
And you would
hold
know
on.
That.
This is Brady's toe?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is Brady's toe.
You
I can
would
tell.
Know that. This is bullshit.
You can tell from the fungus.
Right,
the
fungus.
I'm doing this to get back at me.
Brady has fungus.
I have some bad news for you. Brady is currently a vaguely puppy-shaped pile of intestines.
Another
Vitra. I assume because of the toe.
He wasn't going to bail on you, though. Like, Brady
right.
was really...
He was standing in the middle of the clearing to meet me, correct?
He totally...
And then he befell... A grisly fate
he became,
fell upon him.
Yeah, he got
just as
splinched.
I saw.
Yeah, uh-huh, yeah. You figured that out after the toe,
Okay,
though.
Listen, I am not saying that's the way we all became the Brady Bunch here, okay? I'm trying to tell you how to get to the main generator tent.
Are you, though?
Yes.
Wait. Are we the Brady Bunch now?
No, okay, let's move past the Brady Bunch thing, all right?
That's kind of a cool name, though.
All right, stop it.
Dang. Right?
It's not bad.
That's how it happens.
You guys hear what sounds like, unmistakably, the sound of long fingertips tracing themselves along the outside of the fortune teller tent. You'd recognize that sound anywhere.
Yeah.
You work at a carnival. Come on.
Mm-hmm. Did you have another date tonight, Beatrice?
Oh, come on!
No. No, Murphy.
No?
I'm still holding a torch for you, baby. No, this is an unexpected visitor. And she flips over her next tarot card. Death.
I would like to shank first and ask questions.
I would like to cast the glitter of darkness.
No, I want to get whatever's outside the tent, like right through the tent.
The blade of a bayonet, but just the blade part, not the gun part. Slashes through the back of the tent, carving and slashing, making an opening for something large to come through.
Oh my
You've
god!
You've only moments.
All right.
Oh my god!
I'm gonna go hide. It's what I do best.
Okay.
I'm gonna protect my only woman.
That's sad.
I'm going. I'm gonna cast Glitter of Darkness, guys.
Okay.
Paint my face the color of the tent walls.
Jesus Christ!
Wow. I like the blood.
Do you want to do a different thing as well?
Sure. Why not? Because I apparently have infinite things in my beard, so I imagine. For
well,
range,
they're finite.
I have like some mace as well, so I'm gonna go.
Possibly.
For
okay.
Some
so hold on.
Too.
Hold on. So that roll of three was Glitter of Darkness.
That was Glitter of Darkness.
Okay. Hold on. Would you roll? Seven? Can't beat that. All right. So, yes, you Glitter of Darkness over yourself.
Over who wants to be Glitter of Darkness?
They're all doing other things.
Just me! Just me!
I am
hiding. You go dark. You are trying to pull mace out of your beard?
Yeah, that's got a little more range
Do
than
that.
My shank.
Do that.
Let's go away.
Oh. Can't beat that. So, you get some mace out of your beard. It's bear mace. You are trying to paint your face to look like the wall of the tent?
And
yes,
on the can of bear
two,
mace, you've scrawled a D, so it now says beer
okay.
mace.
Yes!
To roll a two again.
Yeah.
You used a reroll and roll for shoes.
Yep.
Wow.
I did. Damn it. I want to use it. I really want this, so.
Are you serious?
Yes. Damn
wow.
it. Yes, I do.
Yeah!
You paint your face
really
to look like the inside of the tent. However,
yeah.
the rest of your body is just normal.
You can paint.
What are you going to defend your only one?
I'm going to reach into my coat and pull out a snake.
Okay, roll for that. 100%.
Damn it.
Jordan!
I can't.
We're going to be calling it Jordan-y.
Okay.
Yeah. What is that? It's a four.
Four.
So you just remembered. You put a snake in your coat last week.
There's a snake in my
it's
boot.
It's dead, but it's there. And you're hiding.
I'm hiding.
Roll the hide.
I'm good at hiding. It's what I do best. Hey, it works.
You hide.
All
you
right,
hide.
I'm going to spend an experience point.
Hiding.
Yeah, hiding.
Sorry.
Hiding too.
It's a very small tent. I don't know what you're going to do.
All right, so for those of you playing along with Roll for Shoes, the home game at home, let's paint the scene for you. A bayonet blade part begins slashing an opening into the back of the tent. Buzz dives underneath the fortune teller's table, becoming immediately concealed. Remind me again your character's name.
Juliet.
Juliet pulls a can of bear mace out of her beard.
Onto which she scrolled a D, so it now says beard mace.
Nice. Lisa Frank very quickly paints her face to look like the inside of a tent, but no other part of her body. Your Isabella, becomes darkness in glitter.
In glitter.
And you pull a dead snake out of your coat and stand in front of Madame Beatrice as the tall, menacing figure births himself through the wall of the tent. All of you are coming with me. I heard you mention the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. Would you like that? Would you like this to be the way we all became the Brady Bunch and die together? And he starts slashing wildly with his bayonet.
Oh boy.
Can't see you, can't see you. You've got bear mace. He's distracted. Faint.
Is this like, this is just fainting too, right?
Yeah, this is just normal fainting.
Okay. Not over a minor thing.
But I still can't beat that. Okay. So you fall to the ground, because ain't nobody going to catch you right now. I can't even see your face, because it looks like the inside of a tent.
Yep.
By the way, I accomplished my secret objective doing that. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
What was it?
I successfully worked every lyric to the theme song to the Brady Bunch in there without anyone specifically calling
out. Did you call out the theme song? Because I knew the Brady Bunch shit was happening.
No, you said but nobody said specifically that was my secret objective. You guys just commented on it.
Motherfucker.
So I did
it. I didn't know I had to be so blatant.
Well now you know after the fact when it benefits me.
Yep, apparently.
However, we have two other compulsions that remain at the table.
Yeah.
Yes.
Completely undiscovered.
Yeah.
And unnoticed by anyone at the table.
I did call her Katniss earlier, though.
Three very lovely
girls. But that must not have been right.
Katniss. It's gotta be close, though. We all right. Be on-
Can you stop whistling?
No, she cannot.
Can you not stop whistling?
Not
I
yet.
I don't know.
She might need a little bit more before she can stop whistling.